Hey guys, what's up? Hopefully my audio is better this time. Excuse the blotchy face, I pick at it when I get anxious. Trying to grow my hair out, so I just picked up my face instead. I don't know, it's getting kind of long for me, considering I usually shave it. Anyways, today marks a year and 4 months on testosterone. Wow. It's been a hot minute. You know, and then I spent most of the day thinking, you know, in the beginning I was like, hurry up, hurry up. I can't wait to see all these changes, and then you know, once they start happening and you lose track of time, oh, it's like I almost wanted to slow back down so I can enjoy it, but you know, more, not that I'm not enjoying it, but you know, it's just moving so fast. So, you know, it's crazy. A year and 4 months, I mean, has really flown by after the initial shock of it all. Changes. The only thing I'm noticing now is I'm getting more and more facial hair as time passes. Obviously not enough to sport a rock, you know. I mean, I have like whiskers all under here and stuff here and on my sides, but it's all patchy. So I just trim it with an electric trimmer because the razor gives me more acne. I'm still fighting acne. They've got me on medicine though, so. Believe it or not, this is actually looking a lot better than it did. I feel like really nauseous. My medicine has made me sick. I've also gotten acne really bad on my shoulders and chest. That didn't flash you guys. But if you look, like all this and that, you know, it's pretty broken out. Definitely getting some definition going on, and you know, that's pretty cool. I don't know if you can even see, I look really pale on this camera. So that's, you know, pretty much the only changes. My voice has pretty much been the same the last couple of months, and, that's about it. So I was thinking about a couple things that I wanted to talk about, and it's taken me a while to collect my thoughts on, you know, somebody. There might be more than one person, but I know one person in particular being really kind of bitter towards me choosing to go into the military thing and stopping transition to do that. And, you know, the main argument is, you know, how can you lie to yourself or not be yourself or something for whatever cause? And what keeps popping into my mind is that, yes, I am trans, but that is not who I am. I don't understand. I mean, nothing against those who do, but to people who make transition their entire life, that's, you know, the only thing you ever want to talk about, or that's all you are. You're not willing to not hide it, but, you know, not flaunt it, you know, for whatever reasons. You know, you don't have to be on HRT. You don't have to have surgery to be, you know, whoever it is you're aiming to be. And you certainly don't have to be out to be a trans person. You know, I don't run around telling people. It's really none of their business, you know. I'm not ashamed of it. I'm not, like, super stealth. If somebody finds out, it's whatever to me. But it's not my objective to make sure my employers know or make sure, you know, my teachers know or my fellow students or whatever it is I'm going to be doing, because it's not who I am. It's a part of me. It's a very small part of me, you know. The ultimate thing is, I'm Ashley, I'm a male, I'm an independent filmmaker, you know, I'm a student. These are who I am. Being a trans person does not make me. So giving up HRT for, you know, whatever time I was willing to give it up does not stop me from being a man. You know, a fucking pronoun does not stop me from being a man. I'm not so sensitive that, you know, I'm gonna shut the world out and lock myself away in a room just so I can say, well, this is me, I'm a Tranny. It's not like that at all, and that's not healthy. You know, sorry if that offends you, to those of you who make it absolutely everything, you know, but it shouldn't be everything, because in the end, that's all you identify with is a thing. You know, what about everything else in this life? There are so many more important things. I'm not saying, you know, avoid it or be ashamed of it. You know, it's okay to be out about it, you know. they're advocates and things like that. You know, I look at the extreme version of, you know, life is nothing but I'm a tranny, as it's a nice way to put this. I'm not a fan of gay pride. I'm not against it, but I'm not a fan of it because of the people who flaunt and rub their sexuality in people's faces. You know, people who take it to an extreme just to make people uncomfortable. That only promotes the negative views towards homosexuals. You know, when I identified as a lesbian, I didn't go around, you know, sticking my tongue down my girlfriend's throat or my hands in her pants, you know, just to get a reaction out of people. And, you know, I think that having pride parades is beneficial until they cross that line that's like, in your face. You know, that's not the right way to go about anything. That's just like people trying to shove their views down our throat. It's not right, you know. The fine line, it's a fine line. We don't know exactly where it's at, but, you know, I identify being an extreme transgendered, this is my life in a box, as, you know, flaunting things. You know, people, if that's all it is, you know, and you don't sit there and say, well, I'm all these other good things, then people are just going to see the one thing that they don't understand, you know. But, like, take myself, for example, people see, you know, all these other things that I am, and then if they happen to find out I'm trans, it's really not that big of a deal because I'm a person. I'm not a transgender. You know, I'm a person. I'm not a label. I'm not a name. I'm just me. So that's why it didn't bother me at all to sacrifice, you know, putting my transition on hold for a couple years. I mean, especially the things that, you know, I was going to be able to do while my transition was on hold. I don't care that you can't be an openly trans person or openly gay person in the military. The military isn't about your lifestyle. When you're in the military, it's about unifying as a group to protect your country. It's not about individualism. And if that's your main concern when it comes to the military, it's probably a good thing that you're not in the military because they don't need people worrying about their personal problems when the ultimate goal is making this country as safe as it can be. You know, and I don't mean that nasty, but it's the truth. You know, if you're selfish, you probably shouldn't be in the military. It's not about that. You know, granted, there are people that go in for financial reasons or whatever, you know, and they do their job to the best of their ability, and that's cool. But if you're just going in there, me, you're not going to be successful, and you're not joining it for the right reasons. You know, so I just had to make a little rant about that, but I'm feeling pretty sick, so I'm gonna get off here and I'll catch you guys later.